All right, it's episode 144 of the Dan and Cody podcast. If you haven't listened to More Gooder Than podcast, then you should keep it that way, because Cody Frederick is now serving a 2-week suspension from the Dan and Cody podcast due to disparaging comments that he made guesting on another podcast. This is the Dan and Cody podcast. This is it. Right here, Cody. You put on those headphones and you go to work.
Why are you yelling?
This is where our message is heard. It's time to get hype. Say it with me.
What are we saying?
Dan and Cody.
Dan and Cody.
Dan and Cody.
Meet Dan and Cody podcast.
Dan and Cody podcast.
Dan and Cody podcast.
Get some.
Dan and Cody podcast.
Cody, 2-week suspension for conduct detrimental to the podcast. Infractions include general belittlement towards me. Cody compared me to a camel on the More Gooder Than podcast. And he accused me of not raising my daughter and questioned my contributions to the podcast. So, in light, we have Charlie War here in Cody's stead.
Hello.
What's up, dude?
How's it going, Dan?
Thank you for being on here and not talking shit about me.
Very good to be here.
It's messed up, man.
Camel?
Yeah, dude, camel.
What do you have in common with a camel?
He said that he is carrying the podcast on his back, and I'm a camel. It's fucked
up,
man. That
doesn't work together, but...
You know, I've guested on several podcasts, and whenever I do, I say I have nothing but good things to say about Cody.
Really?
It's fucked up, dude.
Well, since I'm on your podcast, should I belittle Cody?
You probably should.
I probably should.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's pretty fucked up. I mean, like...
I wish I knew him better so I had, like, the dirt.
Yeah, but, like, we try to be a cohesive unit. We try to bounce jokes off each other, be friendly, and then we guest on other podcasts, but we don't talk shit about each other.
That's betrayal.
It's messed up. So
2 weeks isn't enough.
It's not enough. So we had a vote. And it was 1-1, for and against. And but if it's tied, in our bylaws, it says 2 weeks. 2 weeks, you're out. All he gets is a 20-second, 30-second like spot on the episode.
Okay.
So he's allowed that.
Wait, so he's gonna have a spot on this episode?
Yeah, he's gonna. What do you call it? Like, air in. Like a correspondent, like a news correspondent.
Hey guys, it's Cody. Sorry I can't be in this episode, but
yeah. So at some point we'll splice in like, and now a word from Cody, who is serving a 2-week suspension.
That's cool though. That's real nice of you to give him that 30 seconds.
Yeah, man. So for those of you that don't know, Charlie War is my buddy that I work with at Prop Store, and he is in a band, and he has a podcast, The Grave Mistakes.
Mistakes in Cinema.
Yeah, man. What do you guys talk about over there?
We find the shittiest horror movies we possibly can. We mm-hmm. do absolutely no research. We just kind of look at the cover and read the title. And if it sounds terrible, we'll watch it and then immediately roast it right after watching it.
But if you don't know it's shitty, so do you sometimes watch good ones?
Yeah.
On
sometimes
accident?
We accidentally... watch good movies, and those are the worst episodes.
Because they're good.
Yeah. Because if it's like a shitty movie that's like knows it's shitty,
yeah,
then it's hard to make fun of because like we're just repeating punchlines.
Right, right, right.
But if it's a shitty movie that's taking itself like serious as fuck,
yeah,
it's the best because it's too easy.
What would you say is a movie that was deceivingly shitty but ended up being really good?
Have you ever heard of that movie called Clown?
No.
Oh.
Clown?
That's a good one, dude. It's basically...
Clown.
It's a film about a man who's a real estate agent, and he finds a clown costume in the attic of one of the houses he's selling.
Yeah.
And like, he's running late to his kid's birthday, so he's like, oh, fuck, I'll just throw this on and show up as a clown to make up for it. Turns out the clown suit has magic powers and turns him into a fucking clown monster.
Is that 2014?
With yeah.
From Eli Roth?
Yep. That's the one.
No shit.
It's surprisingly good.
What's Eli?
Yeah.
Eli Roth is known for his...
Eli's let me down in the past.
Yeah?
The Green Inferno?
You didn't like that?
No.
Dude, I just watched that with Jenny.
Oh, really?
We were into it. But it has its, like, oh, come on, like, bullshit moments.
This is why I don't like The Green Inferno. It is a spiritual successor to the classic Cannibal Holocaust, which is
right.
One of the gnarliest fucking movies I've ever seen.
Dude, you still never given me that.
Oh, I haven't.
I gotta watch it.
Let me bring that to you.
Yes, please.
You need to see it. But it's got, like, this movie is from, I'm pretty sure it's like late 70s, and like all the animals that die in the movie are actually killed. Like, those are real animal deaths. And like, the gore is just so realistic. Like, the people that made it, like, went to court because they thought it was a snuff film.
Really?
Yeah. That shit was banned in most countries.
And it's a nod. It's a nod to Green Inferno is a nod to Cannibal Holocaust.
Yeah. So I was hyped when I first saw the trailer. And then I saw Eli Roth's name. I was like, don't do me dirty, Eli.
And you think he did you dirty?
Yeah.
I think it was a little too funny. Like, in all right. So Green Inferno is about these kids who they're like activists or like wannabe activists, and they want to like. They want to go to these like native tribal places and like chain themselves to trees and like protest. And but they end up getting picked up by like this native painted tribe of cannibals.
Yeah.
And they just slowly get eaten up.
It takes place in like the Amazon, right?
I believe so. Yeah.
Yeah.
But the one part that I was like, this is kind of bullshit, is when they like stuff the weed, they stuff like a bag of weed down their dead friend's carcass because they know that the tribe is going to eat it. And then they like slow roast him, and then the whole tribe eats the guy, and then they like the whole tribe is like stoned.
Yeah. So fucking dumb. I was so mad, dude, because... In the original, in Cannibal Holocaust, like, it's the same thing. Like, these, like, privileged white kids go to the Amazon to do good or whatever.
Yeah.
But they, like, go over there, and they're, like, just a bunch of shitheads, and they're, like, lighting their huts on fire and shit. So the white people are the bad guys. So it's, like, they get captured and, you know, brutally murdered and tortured. And the whole time, you're just like, fuck yeah! Gear them! Kill Whitey!
What?
No, it's the shit.
So you start taking the side of like of the,
oh yeah,
of the native tribe.
Oh yeah, because they're up to no good.
Damn, I didn't realize this is on Prime Video for $2.99.
Cannibal Holocaust?
Yeah.
If you can't wait till tomorrow,
do it. No, I'm not watching it tonight. Fuck that. Oh, and it's on Shudder too.
Oh, do you have Shudder?
No.
Oh.
It's like. I know I want it. I know I could really like get down with it, but I know after like 3 days, I like won't watch it, and then it's just another subscription that I have like running.
My whole thing with Shudder, I don't have it, but I'm probably going to get it. I just feel like most of the content on there is gonna be garbage.
Yeah,
because it's all horror.
It'll just be like indie horror crap.
Yeah, and I'm not trying to watch any college students like thesis. Put on film, which is, you know, have you ever seen that movie Beyond the Black Rainbow?
No.
That's what that bullshit is. Just a fucking art film turned spooky.
Really?
I can't do those ones. But like the director of that film made a sequel called Mandy with Nick Cage, and it's my favorite horror movie of the year so far.
What's it called?
Mandy.
Mandy.
Yeah.
What's that about?
It's like really atmospheric. It starts out as a thesis, but then progresses into an actual fucking horror movie. And it's great. It's Nick Cage and this chick just living out in the woods. And this like cult comes to town and fucking like summons these weird fucking demon biker dudes. And they break in their house, steal her away, and then they burn her alive. So whole rest of the movie is just Nick Cage just like gunning for him.
It's like I gotta
foaming
find her
at the mouth, dude. It's so sick. He's all old and out of shape.
Dude, that's what's up. Like movies now with like just a simple story are now like the best.
Yeah.
It's like I don't know if that's a good thing or a bad thing. If it's a sign that like we as people watching movies don't really we don't want a lot of details. We just need one motive. And it's like, all right, go. Like John Wick.
Yeah.
Everybody fucking loves John Wick.
Yep.
What's the
perfect
story?
Perfect movie.
Yeah. Dude gets his dog killed by the mob and then kills all of them.
Yeah.
That's the movie. Roll the credits.
John Wick 2. Dude gets his car stolen and beat up. Kills everyone.
Kills mob again. John Wick 3. Hopefully it's the same thing.
Yeah. What else does he have to lose, though?
I don't know. Leg?
Oh.
Then, like his girl. He gets a girlfriend. Well, did you see the end of John Wick 2?
Yeah.
Yeah.
Well, I saw it in theaters, and I have terrible memory for movies. Mm. That's why we do the podcast right after watching it.
Oh, okay. Yeah, but well, basically, I think like everyone's been activated to give him like a 24-hour head start.
Oh, right. It, like,
and then it's just like,
all sets right. up the perfect sequel.
Yeah. It's like now every agent is after his ass. Dude. But horror's the shit.
Yeah.
No. It's a great genre.
Dude, it's mostly all I watch, honestly. This is probably going to sound weird, and you're... I don't know. Hmm. I don't know how this is going to make you view me, but...
I don't care.
All I watch is horror movies and cartoons, dude.
That's cool. Okay. That's fine.
All right.
Dude, I my family loves horror movies. There's something about them that, like... It's fun. We were watching this like documentary about like scare, like haunts, mm-hmm. like homemade haunts, like McCamey Manor.
Oh,
you heard of that place?
Is that the one where it's just like one guy that runs the whole fucking thing?
Yeah. He runs a thing. He picks you up at some random spot. He brings you to his house with like all these actors or whatever. And they like, they legitimately torture you.
Never in a million years.
Fuck no.
I saw that shit too, dude.
And you have to bring, like, to get in, you have to bring like 2 pounds of dog food.
Oh yeah, that's all you have to pay him.
Yeah,
but you also have to sit there for fucking hours filling out all the paperwork and like, him taunting you.
It's like, I will not sue you if you make me eat my own barf because you made me like drink my own urine.
The old 1-2.
Yeah, that shit. But like, we were watching this documentary about these people that make haunts, and they make like homemade haunted houses, and it's like the thrill of being scared is also fun. Like, I feel like it triggers the same like part of your brain that it's excitement, and it like how you process the fear. There's a lot of people laugh because it's the same sort of pleasure. I feel it's almost the same thing.
I completely agree.
You know.
Like, for me, I'm pretty desensitized, man. Like, when I watch horror movies, it's like a challenge. Like, I dare you to fucking scare me. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
I'm, like, looking for it all the time.
Like, creep me out a little bit. Like,
So, like, it's gotten to the point where only, like, the most fucked up movies, like, really, like... Because I get disturbed easier than I get, like, scared. You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm.
So, it's, like, movies like Holy Mountain and a Serbian film.
Oh, no.
Oh,
no, thank you.
Yeah.
I've heard a lot of bad things about that film.
Oh, it's awful. It's a decent movie, though, I got to say.
So do you want to be disturbed or do you want to be scared?
I'd rather be scared because it's much more fun.
Mm-hmm.
But being disturbed is still, I still like it because, you know, it will, like, I'll dwell on it.
Yeah. You know
what I mean? And it will, like, cause me to reflect.
Yeah. What gets me in horror movies is... possession and like
the class
and like a hint of like religion, like if it's like haunted houses, I'm not into like Insidious or like Amityville Horror or whatever. I don't like the house is alive thing,
right?
And I've got over very quickly. I hated how it seems like there was a point in time where like all horror movies were like oh, this is an evil thing chasing us and fighting us. And then at the end, you realize, like, oh, you just needed to, like, give it a rose. Or like, and then it was
you
actually...
You just needed some love.
Right. It's like, you needed to hug the ghost at the beginning of the movie, and then it wouldn't, like, jump out of the TV and kill you. Like, The Ring, like Samara. Like,
right.
It was just like, oh, you didn't understand.
Yeah.
Like, she just wanted to be, like, rescued. But like that shit I don't appreciate. But like, yeah, a lot of religion. I don't know, because like religion is real. There's a real element there,
right?
And yeah, that's just what freaks me out. Exorcist, like,
I know,
like
I
something
totally
being
agree.
In you, mm-hmm. you know, and it's making you do some shit. Like that freaks me out.
Right. Yeah, and like for me, it's like one of the things that gets me the most is just like literal psychosis. Like, you know, House of a Thousand Corpses, Devil's Rejects, those mm-hmm. movies.
Oh,
dude,
yeah.
Those people are so fucked in the head.
Yeah.
And that could have, I mean, it's happened. Dahmer, yeah. fucking Ed Gein, like that shit has happened. But this is a whole family of them.
Yeah.
All like-minded individuals. Just fucking.
The Strangers.
Oh, yeah. I just saw Pray at Night the other night, and it was one of the worst movies I've ever seen.
You saw what? The Strangers?
Strangers Pray at Night.
Oh, yeah, I heard that wasn't good.
It was fucking trash.
You know, like Brian went to see that.
He saw the screener, huh?
And he, well, yeah, it was like, what do you call it? Like a test screening.
Right.
And he was like, it's okay, but the ending's weird. So I guess they didn't change the ending from when he saw it.
Oh, God. That's probably why I saw it, because it was like, oh, yeah, I heard it was kind of weird. That sounds good.
You took advice from Brian on movies?
Yeah.
Big mistake, man.
Have you talked about Brian on here before?
No. Okay. Probably not directly. Maybe indirectly.
Brian's this dinkus we used to work with. He's up in Portland now, and he'll never hear this.
I love you, Brian, if shit. You do hear this. See you in hell, motherfucker.
Your brother sucks cock in hell.
God. But no, like The Strangers is the first one is fucked up because it's like these are just they, you know, you didn't like wrong them. You didn't like steal their land. They, you were just home.
Yeah. That is like that quote has stuck with me.
Yeah. You were home.
That's why
they just want to kill you. There are people out there that just want to murder you.
Yeah.
And that is a big fear.
Yeah.
Jenny gets scared as shit because of all the goddamn murder podcasts she listens to.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh. I'm all about those too, dude.
They're intense.
It's all just dark shit and Looney Tunes for me.
Now time for Rugrats.
That's how I calm myself down. Just watch a bunch of babies splash around in the mud.
And then a Serbian film.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. And then watch babies doing other things.
No. My God.
Dude, that movie. I highly recommend just get it out of your system. Nothing will ever faze you again.
I don't know if I want to be that desensitized, though.
Yeah, it sucks.
It's like you the Charlie that watched that is not the Charlie here today. You know?
No.
Like you're just forever changed.
He left me. He left me right when the credits started rolling.
You're like, oh, God.
Yeah. I mean, the special effects aren't that good in that movie, so it's kind of funny, mm-hmm. honestly. But like, if you're one of those people who like sees something,
yeah.
and like you can't really escape the fact that it's fake as fuck,
right?
You're just thinking about what is happening.
Yeah,
it's gonna fuck you up. Yeah,
shit, man.
Yeah. Dude, straight up kills a guy with his dick, like shoves it in his eye socket and kills him.
Oh my God.
Yeah.
No, and I can't.
That
and you well, see it.
Yeah. Yeah. You see it. It's the fakest dick I've ever seen in my life, though.
Like,
I gotta say, they could have spent a little more money on the prop cock.
Faker than Dirk Diggler's dick in Boogie Nights?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah?
Oh, yeah. This thing is, like, fucking purple. It's like maroon. Like, it's not a human color. He's a white guy.
Speaking of dicks.
Yeah.
have you heard of manspreading?
I've heard... Yes, that's one of those things where it's just like you're a big man using your privilege by spreading your legs too wide.
Yes.
Okay. Please tell me more.
Well, like some video came out and it's a fake viral video. Mm-hmm. Like, well, the video went viral, but it was turned out that it was fake. But this girl was going around on subways and pouring bleach on guys on the subway who had their legs like sat down and their legs are out, like their legs are wide, because they were man spreading. So man spreading is like Charlie said, when you are sitting down as a guy and your legs are in like a V shape.
That's just how my body normally forms that way, dude.
Right? Yeah,
like I can't comfortably sit with my legs closed.
Yeah, like I don't know if people understand that like we have dicks and. Like to be completely comfortable, you can't just sit with your legs together.
No.
Because there is something there.
You see these thunder thighs I got down here? If I close them, they just crush my balls.
Yeah. We got tree trunks here, guys. Like, yeah. it's not because we were men and we think that we're like the greatest species on earth.
Yeah. Quaff my aura.
Yeah. I'm not like sitting on a throne every time I sit down. No. I don't want to crush my dick. And I'm not even saying that I have a huge dick. I'm just saying it's probably a regular average size penis. With balls that I can't shut.
Yeah.
Can't shut completely.
No.
No.
Not at all.
It's not a thing.
Mm-mm.
But, I mean,
gotta cut us some friggin' slack, you know? We got things that hang down.
Right.
Down there. It's like, I'm lucky when I don't sit on them. When I sit down.
It's not yet. I mean, I just flew on a plane today. And I, because of this sort of outcry about man spreading, I was a little more what do you call it,
courteous.
I was like a little more like aware of like, yeah, is someone gonna think that I'm man spreading right now? But no, I'm a bigger dude. Like, my leg's in the aisle. You know, I'm not trying to hurt anybody.
No,
I'm very wide.
Yeah,
so like I'm like leaning out.
See, that's one of those things too. It's like you could be a bigger dude and, you know, your legs are spread, so you're man-spreading. But I will never be one of those people that reclines as far back as they can on a fucking airplane, dude.
I did it.
Oh, that's two strikes.
Is that bad?
Man-spreading and reclining to the back?
It's a chain reaction.
I know.
It's
but
like if everyone goes back, we're all good.
I know. But the people behind me, I just feel so bad because I hate it when the person, because I'm a bigger dude. So
yeah,
the person,
you're a big guy.
Yeah, if they lean back all the way, they're crushing my knees. Which causes my legs to close and crush my balls.
Right.
It's a chain reaction.
It's a chain reaction.
Yeah.
Dude, I did. The person in behind me was like using my seat to like get up.
Oh.
So they like were like
yank on your head.
Yeah. Up. So they did that like three or four times during the flight. And then I was like, oh shit, I forgot to like go back.
So when he got back.
So I went. No, I went back and what I didn't realize was that he was, he was actually like sleeping forward. So like he's, yes, like curled over, probably like elbows on the like table, mm-hmm, and like sleeping like this. But I came back and then he got the pull up on me too, and I was like, oh shit, well, let me just take this thing as far back as I can because I'm very cramped.
Yeah. I
gotta
hate
do
flying. It's the worst.
It sucks.
As a bigger gentleman, I can guarantee it's like one of the least comfortable spots we could be in.
Yeah, it used to be, flying used to be a luxury. It used to be like only the hoity-toity has got to fly places, but now it's the bus in the sky.
Yeah.
It's very much a bus.
Dude, I didn't fly for the first time until I was 21.
What?
That was the first time I ever flew, and it was for job training in Texas.
Really?
Yeah.
What were you job training for?
Safety clean. That's when I was getting into confined spaces to clean out acid tanks.
Oh, what?
Doing hazardous waste cleanup.
Did you have to wear like hazmat suits?
Oh, yeah. Straight up Breaking Bad. Like the
really?
Full get up.
You're like
110 degree Arizona weather getting into sulfuric acid tanks to pressure wash them out.
Are you fucking serious?
Million gallon tanks.
How big is a million gallon tank, you think?
It's fucking huge, dude. It's like, it's probably double the size of your living room.
Mm-hmm.
And then I want to say maybe like 100 feet up.
Really?
Yeah.
And you'd have to like just get in there and like pressure wash it?
Yep.
And what if it got on your suit?
If it got on your suit, you're fine. But it's gotten in my suit. I have scars on my chest from it. Not from like that specific tank, but like a smaller one where you like could clean it from the outside.
Uh-huh.
And you just hit the side of the tank the wrong way and it just blasts out at you.
Oh.
And it fucking landed like right in the gap because you wear a hood and everything, and it landed right in the gap and just rolled down my chest and just started eating into me.
What'd you do? Just were you like, did you scream?
I had to strip down butt naked. I screamed at first because I'd never felt it before, but it literally eats you. It feels like a bunch of ants digging into you.
Oh,
so I had to
shit.
Strip down butt naked and run through this factory. We were at like a Haagen-Dazs factory. Yeah, like some ice cream factory. And I had to strip down butt naked and run across the floor to the emergency shower and fucking blast off. It sucked.
So what is Haagen-Dazs doing with that type of acid in there?
A lot of like food manufacturers use that shit. Mm-hmm. I don't know exactly what they use it for. It's an agent. We went over this before about the yoga mat.
Yeah, we were before we started the podcast. We were talking about McRib sandwiches and how everyone tells you like, oh, they got yoga mats in their McRib sandwich. And I was like, because I love McRibs. Actually, guys, it's a it's a chemical bonding agent that is also used in yoga mats. It's not actually the yoga mat in the McRib sandwich. They just share a trait that keeps them together.
It's just the catalyst.
Chad, it's just a catalyst. Got him.
Ooh.
But, yeah, so you had to run around butt naked. What did people say?
No one said shit, dude. Were they going to say, ah, look at that guy. He's fucking being eaten alive by some kid ass and well, like, nerd.
No, I mean, like, did they know, like, what was going on? Or were you running, like,
oh, well,
like
everyone,
Ricky Bobby, like, I'm on fire?
Yeah. Well, I was, like, sprinting, dude, because you have to get it off as quick as you can or else it's going to do more and more damage.
Right.
So, like, I was, like, running and I was, like, at that point, I wasn't yelling anymore or screaming. I was just like, ooh, like fucking butt naked, just like sprinting.
That might even be worse than yelling, like the, ooh,
Bobby.
Yeah, so did you run to like the bathroom to like wash it off more? Or
no, there's like emergency showers like in the warehouse.
Oh.
Like with that crew, like every time you go to a job, you have to like know exactly where those things are because if that shit happens, you need to be in there as fast as fucking possible.
Like at the, like in science class, those like emergency showers?
Not like that. No, it's like a full thing you get into.
Oh, it's like a
yeah, it's like a curtain chamber? In like a little kiddie bathtub, basically.
Damn.
So, like, you get in there, and then it's just, like, fucking rain on you.
Right.
Yeah. But they have eyewash ones, like, all over the place where you just press the little lever, and it just blasts. Yeah, like, two streams, like, directly into your eyeballs.
Fuck.
I've never had to use one of those, though.
What? So what happens after? Is there, like, an incident report? They have to sit you down and be like, so, Charlie, tell me about what happened today.
Yeah, they had to take pictures of my tits. Make sure they weren't too beat up.
So somewhere there's like burn. You're like a burn victim in like a in some kind of instruction book.
Yeah, yeah. Because I mean, it's pretty nasty, dude. Even when it's off, like it just throbs, and it's like it was just meaty, you know, and it scarred me.
Oh man,
I grew out my chest hair because of it.
That's tough, man.
I got drapes.
You got the drapes. Yeah. Drape that shit up.
Yeah, had to.
Damn, dude.
Yeah, that was. I mean, I did that job for 2.5 years. And I don't regret it.
Yeah.
But I definitely.
How early in the job was that?
That incident? Was probably like 1.5 years in.
Yeah.
Yeah. That's when I was starting to get too comfortable. You know what I mean?
Right.
I'm like, oh, fuck this thing.
I don't need this suit.
Come on, Dan. I'm not stupid. I had the suit on. I was just wearing it loosely.
Right. Tie it around your waist. That's it.
You know, dude, it's just sulfuric acid. This shit's bitch made.
Yeah, whatevs.
Yeah.
And now a word from Cody Frederick, who is serving a 2-week suspension.
You are listening to Cody in Greece. Blah, 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 Greek words. All right, hey, everybody, how's it going? I have done the worst thing you could possibly do. I've said terrible things about my podcast partner, and he's banned me. He's sent me away. I am no longer a man that can be available to be on the podcast. Right now, Dan has pushed me aside because, unfortunately, I was on the More Gooder Than podcast, a fantastic podcast run by 3 individuals by the name of Donnie, Chris, and Corey, and we talked about all kinds of Wyatt Earp stories from Tombstone to the movie Wyatt Earp, and unfortunately, I said some terrible things about Dan, and he has put his foot down. He has said, no, Cody, no more. And he has banned me. And here I am in Greece, banned from even the United States because of the things I've said to Dan. And here I lay in my hotel room, banned from the Dan and Cody podcast with my partner, my amigo, Dan Hill. So that being said, here I am in Greece. What's happening? What's going on? Why? Well, you know the why. The ban sent me to Greece. And here I am in Greece. It is basically my really first full day here. And my wife and I had visited Poseidon's Temple. It's this grandiose pillared structure atop this hill that is on the tip peninsula of the southern edge of the peninsula of where Athens lies. And we are sitting here at this Sunio resort. I mean, this band from the Dan and Cody podcast is rough. This resort's like a 5-star resort. It's kind of allowing us to get our heads comfortable with the time change and experience the wonders of Greece. So a couple thoughts. Greece in general, blown away. Amazing, beautiful. It reminds me of Idaho, the hills, the small trees, the dry, arid air, but this beautiful sea. You look out in the Mediterranean and you're just blown away by what you're seeing. It's this clear water. And so today we went to the Temple of Poseidon. They had this cafe up there. Then you walk up to the temple and you look out over the sea and you see a couple islands, and it's just a beautiful sight to be seen. And they have, and it looks like, you know, 150 years ago, people had gone up there and they scribbled their names in. They said, John Henry was here, date 1875. And I'm like, wow, 1875. This thing was built in 1440 BC. And you're thinking, 1875, that wasn't that long ago at all. 440 BC. Mind-blowing. The age, the fact that it was able to, you know, stand the test of time. Earthquakes throughout Greece. You know, weather, rain, wind, everything. And here we are looking at this incredible structure that apparently, as I was, we were told in a taxi ride today, that this, some location where Apollo's, there's an Apollo, like kind of the temple of Apollo, and then the Parthenon equate to a perfect triangle. It's just something that helps you gain perspective. And that's where I'm at. I'm gaining perspective, especially after the horrible things I said about Dan. For example, I said, I'm carrying Dan. I'm like, it's like carrying a camel on your back. That's how it is with Dan. But it's not. Dan, you are the camel that I'm riding on, man. Without you, I'm not going forward. And I'm learning my lesson, man. I'm gaining perspective by being here in Greece. And, you know, next week, I'll have a little more information. I'll be in Santorini, and then I'll go to Athens. And by the time you hear this next podcast, you'll get a little bit of Cody in Greece, and that's what you're going to get, man. And I'm sorry. Please take me back. And in the meantime, I'll struggle my way through this Grecian ban, this ban to Greece, to find who I am and where I belong in the Dan and Cody podcast. Until next time, friends, stay true to yourselves, do the right thing, and believe in tomorrow.
You know Santorini?
Santorini?
Yeah.
No.
Officials in Santorini. Let me just Google.
Oh, that's a place.
Yeah.
I thought it was like some sort of black magic.
Oh, yeah. You know, Santorini.
I don't practice Santorini.
Yeah. I ain't got no crystal ball. Oh, Santorini in Greece, actually.
Oh.
They banned fat tourists from riding their donkeys.
Smart.
You think so?
Yeah.
There's nothing wrong with that, right?
No, those poor donkeys, dude. Like, I think there definitely should be a weight limit.
Yeah.
It's not just visibly fat, right? It's not like, oh, you're a little chubby, get the fuck out of here.
No. Someone, like, eyes you up, and they're like, nah, she can't ride the donkeys.
I still think that's fine, dude, for the donkey's health.
Yeah, you've got to, like, you've got to protect your product.
Exactly.
At that point, the donkey's the product.
They're probably their friend, too, you know?
Yeah.
The donkeys are probably their pets.
It says,
or something.
It says the popular cruise destination is often awash with tourists. Up to 1,200 visitors a day arrive on cruise ships between May and October. And like it's no Greece, like this place in Greece is known for its hills and steep paths, and the donkeys are used to help like transport people to areas that they can't reach. But they have a problem with like all of these fat people touring there.
Yeah.
And they're now saying that you cannot be heavier than 100 kilograms to ride the donkeys.
Do you have any idea what the conversion to pounds is? I want to know if I'm allowed to ride the donkey.
Yeah, can you ride the donkey? 100 kg.
I mean, that's a little different because, I mean, you kind of need the donkey to get around these paths and shit. I think if you're just like fat, you shouldn't go to Greece. I think that's...
220.
220?
I can't ride the donkeys.
I'm 5 pounds over, dude. I shouldn't go to Greece.
We can't ride the donkeys, man.
No, there's no Greece in my future.
Yeah. It adds, donkeys should be given a reasonable amount of appropriate food and fresh drinking water, and they should not work long hours with ill-fitting saddles.
Mm. Or like 230 pounds crushing their spine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
The obese and overweight tourists combined with the lack of shade and water as well as the sheer heat and 568 cobbled steps is what's causing such a problem. Then they're quoted as saying there should be a weight restriction with donkeys. It should be no more than 50 kg. But how would that be imposed and who would be there to make sure that happened?
Dude, scales are so cheap.
Yeah, you just get a scale. Yeah. Can you imagine an American tourist like, and they're like visibly large, and you're like, please step on this scale? They'd be like, "Fuck you!" They go, "No, I'm not doing it."
I feel like if they had signs just saying like there is a weight limit for this donkey ride, the fat people would kind of probably just like shy away from it because they don't even want to know if they.
Right.
Are allowed or not.
It would just be just put up a warning.
Yeah. Warning. Like, heads up, we're about to fucking weigh you in public.
Weigh stations ahead.
All trucks pull to the right. Yeah.
Turn back if you don't look like this. And it's a skinny person.
No, I definitely agree with that, though. Like, I'm one of the people that wouldn't be allowed on the donkeys. And I
couldn't do it.
Yeah.
I'm okay with that. I don't need to... Dude. Me and Jenny went to Germany on a vacation with another couple, and there was an option to like ride in these like horse-drawn carriages like up this like freaking hill, or just walk it. And we were like, let's just walk this.
Right.
But so many people take the lazy road,
and then those people eventually become the fat people that can't ride the donkeys.
Yeah. So like if you're screwing yourself.
Exactly.
Take a couple less donkey rides, and then you'll be able to ride the donkeys.
Exactly. Dude, if you're already able to ride the donkeys, if you don't take the donkeys, you'll continue to be able to ride the donkeys. Like, just do that.
That's right, man.
It's logic.
Their quote, another quote, "We don't want to stop the locals making a living or using donkeys on the steps, but to look after them in a fair and humane way." Mm-hmm. So hopefully the donkeys will all get the appropriate care that they deserve.
Aw.
I mean, I think from an animal cruelty perspective, this is a good thing.
Yeah.
But I don't know. I don't know how it'll fly with.
I would literally consider it animal abuse if I put my big fat ass on that fucking that little guy. Oh, you just showed me the picture,
dude. He can't ride the.
No.
She can't ride that donkey.
No. I'm
like,
sorry.
Get off. You need a horse.
Dude, if you shop at Moo Moo Barn, like, you don't get on the donkey.
And I'm not...
You should have more, like, pride.
Yeah.
Like, you look way larger than that donkey.
Yeah. Like, we're not trying to fat shame or anything. No. But, like, common sense law.
Especially since we're included in the group.
Right. Yeah. We can't ride either, folks. Yeah. But we're not going to try to.
No, I would hate to see a picture of myself on a donkey.
If you're as big or bigger than the donkey, don't ride the donkey.
Exactly. That's like putting a donkey on your fucking back.
Poor Dunks.
I know.
Poor Dunks, man.
It's like one of the few animals I like really have a soft spot for. That,
really?
Turtles and elephants.
Turtles, elephants, and donkeys.
Yeah.
How come?
Well, donkeys are just like the small people of the horse world, so I feel for that.
Are they inbred, though? Is that a thing?
I don't know. Because mules, I don't think they were like genetically like manipulated in any way.
Let me.
Because mules, for sure, have been around. Uh-huh. I think donkeys are the product of mules and horses, aren't they?
A domestic hoofed mammal of the horse family with long ears and a braying call. Used as
a braying call?
Used as a beast of burden. What?
Who wrote that? That's Sean right there.
The donkey or ass is a domesticated member of the horse family. The wild ancestor of the donkey is the African wild ass. The donkey has been used as a working animal for the last 5,000 years.
Yeah.
They're a working animal.
They've been around.
Why are they the working animal and horses are like... Well, I guess horses are a working animal,
horses
too.
Horses have hauled plenty of shit. Like
the
Clydesdales just hauling kegs of Budweiser everywhere.
Right. That's, oh, those big badass horses. Yeah. The scientific name for a donkey is Equus asinus.
Asinus.
A-S-I-N-U-S.
Equus asinus.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
See, because that's the thing. I don't like horses. Donkeys are cool, but horses creep me the fuck out.
Horses creep you out?
Yeah. You could see it in donkeys' eyes. They've got like kind eyes. They like have long lashes. They bat them. Horses just have like that weird dead look.
Yeah.
You know what I mean?
Yeah. Something about horses.
Yeah. And they just know they could fucking explode your rib cage with one kick.
Yeah. But I feel like somewhere I learned that like donkeys are, the donkeys are like inbred. And that's why they're smaller and like shittier.
They're like the fucking... The horrible swamp people of the horse world.
They're the redheaded stepchild of the horse.
Yeah. I swear I heard somewhere that it was like a horse slipped it in a mule and they shat out a donkey.
All right. But you like turtles too.
Yeah, turtles are the shit, dude.
Turtles are cool.
Dude, they're more than cool.
They're all right.
They're far more than cool.
They're very slow.
They're very slow. They're born old as fuck.
They're born old.
Yeah. They're just old people, dude.
I like their shells.
Yeah.
But I feel bad for them. It seems like very constrictive.
Yeah. Well, you know they have nerve endings in their shell. So like when you rub their shell, they feel it.
And really?
Like, yeah. I used to, like my buddy had this tortoise.
Mm-hmm.
And you rub his shell and he'd go.
Whoa.
Like.
They can feel that on the shell.
Yeah. They've got nerves in that hard shell. So
interesting.
Yeah, and when they're doing their mating, their whole like mating call, they just headbang. Like, that's how they attract their mate. Just dun, 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 dun.
But I don't know. I think I got turned off to turtles when I watched like a video of one having sex. It was disgusting.
Really?
Yeah. Like its mouth was just open and it was making this like horrendous squeal.
Little dinosaurs.
I don't
man.
Want to repeat it. It was just nasty. And I was like, they're nasty.
Have you ever seen that video of that turtle? He's not fucking. He just has his big ass. He has a huge dick.
Yeah.
I don't know if this turtle was just like well endowed.
Yeah.
But he just has it flopped out on the concrete.
Was he man spreading?
Yeah, for sure, dude. He was like doing the splits. And he's just going and just blasts all over the concrete.
Oh, my
huge
God.
Huge turtle load. Yeah.
Ugh.
I've never even seen turtle balls. Like, where you keep all that?
Just respect across the board for the turtle.
Yeah, dude. He's just all around. He's a man.
I mean, okay. You put it like that, I'm sold on turtles.
Turtles are sick.
Turtles are great.
And you already know why elephants are the best. Come on.
Because
they're kind-hearted, gentle giants like myself.
They're big. They're big on the earth. They're the biggest. Are they the biggest animal?
Land
on earth?
Mammal.
Land mammal.
Yeah.
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 I like elephants. I think they're cool.
Wow. You're really downplaying all my favorite animals, dude.
I like Dumbo.
Dumbo. More like dumbass.
Dumbo was cool. Dumbo could fly. Dude. Dumbo's a great movie it's another Disney movie that says to like embrace what makes you different. Them big ass ears.
Yeah. I know, but I just think real elephants are way sicker than cartoon elephants. Because like, dude, I just recently saw a video of this elephant like dive into a river to go save this guy that was drowning. Like grabbed him with his trunk and like hauled his ass out of the river.
Come on, let's go. That's pretty cool.
Dude, it's the best. fucking best.
I played around with the idea of getting an elephant tattoo.
Oh, yeah?
Because they're cool. But, like, I wanted to get it like kind of like this, like sort of tribally, super detailed. But I don't know. I guess I like tigers. I like zebras.
Tigers and zebras.
Yeah. Zebras are fun.
So you... Like, primarily, like, the what is it, savannah? Wildlife? Mm. Tigers? No, tigers are in, like, the jungle and shit.
Yeah, they're jungle-fied. Yeah. I think tigers are in Africa, but they have jungles.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I'm confused.
Bro, where do tigers live? Who knows?
Palmdale.
Hello there, Dank Odies. I am Joe Merle.
I'm Phil.
And together we are Those Movie Guys Podcast here with your weekly movie recommendations. And this week, Phil, I am going with 1994's Clerks. I rewatched it this week, and the further we get away from Clerks, I feel like the more relevant it becomes in helping to define an entire generation of not only just filmmakers, but pop culture. The idea that you could talk about pop culture in the movies, and it's extremely relevant, and it kind of brought all those nerds out a little bit. It was like,
it was cool to talk about.
Yeah, it's safe. It's a good place now. Don't be scared of it. The directorial and writing debut of Mr. Kevin Smith, it's still fun. Still good. So that's my choice this week.
Different style. Some would say an acquired taste, but most people that have watched it a long time ago.
Right. So I was like, give it another watch and see what you think. And what do you got? What do you got on deck for us today?
I went with something I promised you I would watch, and that's 1988's Night of the Demons.
Very nice.
I really, I didn't know nothing about it. It's on Amazon Prime, but I really liked it.
Yeah.
It was that slasher horror comedy shit that I like.
It was just perfect for the time. I mean, there is the remake, so if you do go to find this, make sure you don't get the Shannon Elizabeth remake. You got to get that original from 88 because it is... Just a so good call, man. I like it during the Halloween season. So that's what we've got for you. We got Clerks and Night of the Demons. So hit up your local Redbox or video on demand service wherever you find
Night
your movies.
Of Demons is in any one of those things.
No, it's in an abandoned Blockbuster in Wichita, Kansas. It's just full of homeless people
and probably horror.
Right, it's the only thing there. So for those movie guys, I am Joe Merle.
I am Phil,
and we'll be back next week with more movie recommendations.
I think it's time for a champion of the week here. You ready for this?
Yes, but please first tell me what that is.
Oh, okay. So, champion of the week. It's a thing we do here at the Dan and Cody podcast where we crown someone in the world our champion for doing like a badass thing.
Oh.
A cool thing.
Oh, so yeah. It's pretty self-explanatory.
Yeah.
The champion of the week. Yeah.
So this week, it is a guy who goes by the Dancing Doc, Tony Adkins. So Tony Adkins has been in the news for... like bringing in like dancing into his practice with kids. So like all these kids will see him with like ailments or just any sort of sickness. And he'll like, before he even gets into the doctory stuff, he like dances with them to like boost their spirits and shit. It's really, really cool.
That sounds great.
And they make like YouTube videos. It's pretty fucking like heartfelt. He's an army veteran and, He shares all these dancing videos with his patients, and like it's his commitment to preserving the magic of childhood. And like he's like big on the whole like that studies have shown that laughter and smiling, encourage physical health benefits, and they lower like stress hormones and shit. So it's just all around badass.
Yeah. Yeah, I totally agree with that too. Like, with laughter is like the fucking best natural medicine or whatever, because
hell yeah, man.
When I'm having a good time laughing and shit, I definitely feel better than I usually do.
It's fun. Yeah. And you, what's your band again?
There's two.
Two bands?
Yeah.
You're in two bands?
Yeah. I'm actually wearing one of those shirts right now.
This Place is a Zoo.
And In Decline.
In Decline.
In Decline.
I didn't know you were in two.
Yeah. In Decline's newer.
Okay.
I've been doing This Place is a Zoo since 2006.
Yeah. Well, then you, like, you know, I mean, you guys don't necessarily dance, but is it, I mean, there's an element of, like, movement.
Yeah, definitely. Have you ever heard of hate moshing? It's actually the exact opposite of that doctor you're talking about.
It's I can assume it's angry moshing.
Basically, yeah. It's you know what hardcore dancing is, right?
Yeah.
Both the bands I play in are like hardcore death metal.
Right.
And so yeah, it's like people like, and I love it, don't get me wrong, but it's fucking hilarious. Like, they get in there and they're just acting like there's like bees attacking them. They're fucking flailing their wrists and arms, doing roundhouse kicks and shit.
And if you get in there, it's all hell's loose. All hell's loose, right?
Yeah, dude. Like, both those bands are still like super underground too. So it's like we mostly play like small venues, mm-hmm, and houses. So we're on the floor right next to those people doing that shit.
Where it's happening.
Yeah.
Have you ever taken a
stray
fist?
Oh yeah. Almost really? Every show. It just happens. Like,
and
my brother plays.
And you're singing.
Yeah. I'm the vocalist of both those bands. And in This Place is Who, I play keys.
Mm-hmm.
And my little brother is the bassist of that band.
Mm-hmm.
So it was like maybe 2 months ago. We were playing this little record store in my hometown.
Yeah.
And it's so small. It's like it packs out every show. Just
yeah.
As many people as can fit in the room, that's how many are there. And
so you're not on a stage. You're on the floor with them, and it's like super close to you.
Yeah. Yeah, no divide. They're just right there. Only the people in front, that's the barrier, because they'll try to, like, you know, keep the others away.
Yeah.
But then a lot of the times there's no one brave enough to stand in the front, so it's just us right in front of the pit.
Oh, shit.
And it's fun, dude. I love it.
Have you ever had to stop and been like, guys, back the fuck up?
No.
Like, we can't play if you guys are going to, like...
No, we would never stop a song, but like in between songs, we'll be, especially at like a record store and stuff like that, we'll be like, hey, like, you guys got to remember, this isn't even a fucking venue. This is a record store.
Yeah.
Like, be careful of the venue.
Yeah.
Like, if you're going to go crazy, do it on each other, not on the fucking merchandise.
Don't break the merch.
Yeah.
Damn, that's got to be intense for like the record store.
Yeah. But they're cool. Voodoo Vinyl, shouts out.
Voodoo Vinyl.
Lancaster Boulevard.
Yeah?
Yeah, dude. They're sick. That's an awesome spot.
They let you play there? You guys play there?
Yeah. We're playing there this Saturday.
Nice. Yeah.
It's free, too. All the shows there are free. We'll have, like, donations out and sell our merch.
Up in Lancaster?
Yeah.
Voodoo Vinyl, y'all.
Yeah. In Decline. Post Nothing's last show.
But even if you hate mosh, you will feel better afterwards.
Oh, 100%. Because, like, I mean, basically what I do...
It's physical activity.
Yeah.
Yeah.
It's great exercise, first of all.
That's right.
Like, not only physically, but mentally, because you're also avoiding other people,
mm-hmm,
and having to be aware of your surroundings at all times, while at the same time trying to put everyone else in the hospital.
Right.
In all seriousness, though, like, no one goes there to hurt anyone. You know? It's like everyone's just dancing and shit. If someone falls, they get helped up. It's like... all good vibes.
Sure, sure, sure.
But just to end that story I was telling, my little brother who plays bass in This Place is Zoo, mm-hmm, at that last show we played at Voodoo Vinyl, we're so cramped up there and we're a four-piece. So it's like drums, bass, guitar, me, all in one little area. And anyways, he was like into it for a second and like flung his bass back and smacked me straight in the head. And I have a fucking scar from it. I don't know if you can see it from there.
Oh, shit.
But it split me open right over here.
Just from him swinging his bass back.
Yeah, the head of his bass just slapped me right in the forehead and just split my skin open. So the rest of our set, I'm just dripping blood.
While you were singing?
Yeah.
I got holy some photos, shit.
Some good ones.
Did you like wipe your blood and just like fucking fling it everywhere?
No, I didn't even know I was bleeding until after we like finished the set. And then everyone was like, holy fuck, dude, you need to go to the hospital. And then I like wiped it off and it was just a spot.
But
you know, it's on your head. It's going to squirt.
The blood makes it even scarier.
Yeah.
It makes a small cut fucking really scary.
Yeah, exactly.
Moxie bit it on the steps a while ago. And like the trim like on the steps, like she caught it right above the nose between her eyes.
Oh god.
And it like split her shit open and like grandma was here and she's like, "Oh my god," like freaking out. She had blood all over.
Did she get black eyes from that?
Nah.
No.
Nah, see, we just but dude, we went to the urgent care. And they did the same shit that like we would have done here. It's like clean it out and like they glued it shut.
That'll be $5,000.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Fuckers, man.
Dude. I will do anything to not go to the hospital.
It's a shame. Yeah. It's a shame we live in this country where it's like it's not just like, oh, we're all human beings. Yeah. Let's take care of each other. If you have a big ass cut, you just get your big ass cut fixed and go home.
Isn't that mind-blowing?
Yeah.
Like, we put so many other things, like, in such a higher priority than just, like, making sure our citizens are healthy.
Yeah, are you all right?
Yeah.
Hey,
we
kind of
need to be alive to consume.
Like, yeah. Yeah, like, just fucking take care. There's enough money.
Yeah.
There's enough money. Take, like, not even a quarter of what we spend on, like, bombs and tanks and shit. And
yeah. That's what I'm saying, too. It's like everyone talks about how overpopulated it is, but it's like it's only like very like specific areas that are overpopulated. I fucking drove through the North or the Midwest like last year, and that shit was fucking barren.
There's nothing there.
There's just little honky hidey holes. That's all they got out there.
Oh, man.
Yeah. So I don't know. I don't get it.
I don't get it either, man.
Yeah.
But I do have a true crime that is very related to Tony Atkins. It's the opposite.
I'm so excited.
It's the opposite of the dancing doc. This woman.
It's the stomping doc.
No, she took it to a different level. This is the doctor who danced during surgery. She got suspended by the Georgia Medical Board.
Have you heard of this video, dude? I've seen the video of it.
You saw the video?
Yeah.
Oh, I can't find the video.
What?
I bet they took that shit down. But yeah, she's a dermatologist who can be seen on video dancing to the hip hop song Cut It. I think that's the one that's like, cut it, skirt, cut it.
It's perfect.
Bah. And while performing the surgical procedure, she was suspended. Yeah. For doing that. People are suing her. She's apparently like fucked up people's surgeries.
Malpractice.
Because of the dancing. It's gotten too much.
See, that's how it is. Dancing is priority over making sure everyone's alive. Like,
she describes herself as the doctor to the stars. And she calls herself someone with a surgeon's hand and a woman's touch. She wanted to be known as the dancing doctor, and someone said, instead of dancing, Miss Rideau said, Dr. Davis Boutte, B-O-U-T-T-E, boot? Boutte?
Boot. That's
bout? Boutte? I don't know. Well, she should have been paying more attention to her work.
I agree.
And someone said, I just wanted my butt a little rounder and smaller. But
but
I can't live like this. It affects my relationship. It affects everything.
Wait, what happened to the butt?
She like fucked up people's butt implants.
So was
doing
it
this
saggy?
Whole like doing this whole like dancing thing. Yeah.
You made it not voluptuous?
Yeah. She's done the opposite of what she's selling.
That sucks.
She says she's done nothing wrong. She says, I'm a surgeon. I'm supposed to be able to multitask.
Oh my god.
So I'm a surgeon. I can dance and do surgery, okay?
It's your ass's fault for sucking.
Yeah.
Oh my god, dude.
Yeah,
that's
man.
Wild.
I mean, it just Oh, Jesus. There's a picture of her. Oh, like,
gimme. Oh, hell yeah.
Look at that.
Dude, yeah, that's the... That, I definitely saw that
video. Is that the video?
Yeah, she's good at dancing, too. I'll give her that.
She's got the hot poker.
Dude, yeah. She can definitely cut the rug, but I don't think she's any... Like, should be cutting human flesh.
See, yeah, it says the video has been removed from social media during this court case.
Oh, that makes sense.
Yeah. I used the videos to demonstrate to the court that we have severe concerns about those practices and evidence to support our contention.
Yeah, okay. I would much rather go to like a dead serious, like boring ass doctor than someone who's like having a great time.
Yeah, you want your doctor to be a little boring.
Yeah.
Be a little weird.
Sense of humor.
I want you to be a little socially awkward because that means that like you were really focused on your books.
Yeah. Like No parties.
You just went to school. Like, don't be a super cool doctor because there's a chance that like I'll get you on like a hangover or something. Or
yeah.
Yeah.
No, I completely agree.
You want to know,
sometimes
doc.
Those edibles last more than a day.
You don't want your doctor knowing how to dance to Cut It. But at the same time, you could be like Adkins and bring like love and joy to your children.
Yeah.
While you're dancing.
Well, that's wholesome. Like, I appreciate that because I'm pretty sure that dude's not doing it while cutting into the flesh of these children.
Yeah, I think it's sort of like an icebreaker for him.
Just get them comfortable so that you can like put them to sleep.
And I think a lot of his patients have physical issues. Mm-hmm. So the dancing probably gives him a rough starting ground of like where he can push the limits and whatnot.
Right. He's got very kind eyes. I trust him already.
Yeah. Yeah, I wanna be his patient.
So, is he just a pediatrician?
I'm not sure what kind of doctor he is. Let's see. Physician assistant from Orange County, California.
Oh, he's close.
Knows just what to do when his patients are feeling a little under the weather.
Dance.
You gotta dance. Sometimes you gotta just dance.
You know, I know for sure, like when I'm feeling sick, I got diarrhea, throwing up. All I need is to go to the fucking club. That's cure what ails me.
You gotta just jump around and dance.
Mm-hmm.
That's
a little hate moshing.
Little hate mosh. Do what you gotta do.
Clean your right out.
I want to tell you about a company called JC Room Blocks. Do you have 10 or more out-of-town guests coming to an event near you? Maybe you have a bris, a wedding, a family reunion, a science convention. Maybe some friends are coming in town and they just want to get drunk in one place. Or your mom's coming into town and she's got 10 brothers and sisters and they need a room so they can all come over to your house and have a bagel. Well, I have the answer for you. JC Room Blocks. They research hotels in the area that you need the rooms. So if you're in San Diego, they're going to find those rooms. They're going to put them together for you. Oh, what? You need to be in Boston for a little bit? No big deal. Go over to Boston and hang out with your Boston friends. You got 10 or 15 of them and you need a room? Fucking Boston. That's what you're going to do. Since they're certified travel agents, they can get you the lowest possible rates. On top of discounted rates, they can also negotiate highly discounted bridal suites, shuttle service, and food and beverage functions. If you mention the Dan and Cody podcast, that's us, they'll waive their fee. That means you don't pay anything, okay? Check them out, jcroomblocks.com. I'm going to repeat that, jcroomblocks.com. They're on Facebook, they're on Twitter and Instagram. Follow them, check them out, get all them rooms!
Do you want to play a game?
I'm down. I love games.
Yeah?
Yes.
You sure?
Oh, why?
When we have guests, I always ask them if they want to play.
What do you mean? Am I sure? What kind of game is this?
I got a game.
To play two people spin the bottle?
Close.
I'm down.
It's very close. It's a little game called Bean Boozled.
Oh, is that the Birdie Bots?
What's Birdie Bots?
They're like shit flavored jelly beans and shit.
Yes.
Oh, I'm down.
You're down?
Yeah, I'm down.
Fuck, yes. I can't believe. All right, cool. Cool. You're like the third guest who's just been like, yeah, let's do it.
Have you been turned down?
Yeah, by my own fucking co-host. Cody Frederick.
God, what a camel.
Jeez.
That guy's a fucking camel, dude.
Yeah, you know what? I'm doing all the heavy lifting on this show.
Eating boogers and dookie.
That's right. All right, so if you've never listened before, we've played this game a couple times. It's called Bean Boozled. And basically, like Charlie said, there's jelly beans. There's a bunch of different flavors. A lot of them look the same. So one flavor is going to be like a good taste. Mm-hmm. The other flavor is going to look the same as that jelly bean, but it's going to be a shitty taste.
Okay.
So here are the flavors. We got spoiled milk and coconut.
Oh.
Rotten egg or buttered popcorn. Barf or peach. Booger or juicy pear. Stinky socks or tutti frutti. Dead fish or strawberry banana smoothie. Toothpaste or berry blue. That's the best.
Yeah, that doesn't sound bad at all.
Yeah, that's the icing on the cake. That's the unicorn you want to go for.
Right.
There's canned dog food or chocolate pudding.
That's not too bad either.
What?
Canned dog food?
Ew, man.
Come on, man. It's edible. You're like, you're supposed to eat it, not like stinky like crust socks and shit. College dorm room sock.
There's moldy cheese or caramel corn.
Mm. That doesn't sound that bad either.
Moldy cheese?
Moldy cheese.
Ew,
it's penicillin.
Dude. Ugh. And then there's lawn clippings or lime. Which also is not
wheatgrass.
Wheatgrass.
Wheatgrass, baby. I take those shots all the time.
You're going to be terrible to play for because you're going to be like, it's not that bad. It's not that bad.
Is this boogers? I love boogers.
I'm used to these. Yeah. All right. So,
no, the rotten milk one is probably like, I'm afraid of that.
Yeah, that one's rancid. So we've got a spinner here.
I have a question. Is it possible that I can get through this game without eating like a shit flavored jelly bean?
Yes.
Okay.
You know why? Because I've used this batch a few games.
Okay.
So like it's been grazed over.
Can you tell me the ratio? Have you been getting, because I'm like trying to count beans right now. Like, have you been getting more stinky beans or like delicious?
There's been a game where I've gotten like all goods.
Oh, fuck. Okay.
So like, I think the odds are getting like worse and worse.
Okay.
All right. Maybe we'll grab that trash can if it's disgusting. Hold on.
Oh, you're going to spit them? You got to swallow, Dan. No spitting.
They're so gross.
My mom.
For you.
There's one thing I learned from my mom. She actually said this. She said, never trust a woman who does not swallow. That's my mama.
Love you, Mom.
I love you, Mom. Shouts to Mama War.
Mama War. What is...
She's a dirty bird.
What is war?
English. I'm mostly Irish.
Your war with two R's.
Yeah.
I've never met a war.
I mean, I have. But right. Like outside of like the family reunion? No.
Yeah.
No. But I've gotten like random Facebook ads. Like, and it's crazy. Like some black people hit me up with the last name War. I'm like, fuck.
With two R's?
Yeah.
That's cool.
It's like, damn.
Have you ever done an ancestry DNA? Like,
no.
23andMe? I have one. I'm scared to take it, though.
Why?
I don't want to be in the grid.
Oh.
I don't want to be in the system.
My fingerprints are in the system. Because I've been to jail.
Sure.
But that's like, they have your biology.
Yeah. That's like, do you want to cook up some Dans? Because you can.
Just make super soldiers.
Yeah, like I don't want to get arrested by me in like 20 years.
Oh, God. Could you imagine?
Know, like a bunch of Dans like knock on my door.
And it's like the youthful, like fucking gonna beat your own ass,
yeah.
Dan.
The Dan who can like ride a donkey whenever he wants because he's under 220 and can like fuck me up. Excuse me, sir. Hey, you know who you're talking to? Talking to me. All right. You spin first.
Oh, come on.
You
bro?
Want me to go first? All right, I'll break the ice. I was trying to be like you offer your guest first.
It's probably not even better to go first or second. It's all the same.
It's probably all bad.
All right, I'll go first.
You sure?
Yeah.
I mean, I'll do it.
I'm sure,
since
dude.
You called me out, I'll do it.
I don't want to turn down your manners. Okay. You've got wonderful manners, and I want to utilize them.
Yeah, you know, like I'm holding the door for you right now.
Yeah, thank you.
You walk in there first.
Do you have any specific rules for the spin?
Just to
give it a good flick.
Give it a good old flick, and then whatever color it lands on.
Oh, come on. Retry. One more retry.
Yeah.
It's in between lines.
Spin it again.
All right.
Spin it flat.
All right. I was trying to get a good twist.
Oh, that's worse. There we go.
Cool.
Oh, man. That's an easy one.
Is that the grass one?
You got to pick. Yeah, pick a. Yeah, it's juicy pear or booger.
Oh, fuck. That's not the... Oh.
Yeah, so you have to pick a speckled green one.
Okay.
You can't just do a solid green. Is that speckled?
Right?
Yes.
Speckled?
All right, he's booger. Going for it. Juicy pear or booger?
If my memory serves me well.
What is it?
It's definitely not a pear.
That's bug.
I don't remember boogers tasting like that. This is worse than boogers.
It's amazing how good they are with like getting the flavor. Is it nasty?
Well, now that I'm just thinking about boogers in my mouth, dude, it's pretty fucking gross. Not gonna lie. I'm gonna eat it though.
Eat it up.
I'm gonna have my share of boogers.
We'll do three rounds.
All right.
All right, you're next.
Come on, Dan.
All right.
Oh, that was fucking horrible.
Juicy pear or booger? Should I do it? Or do it? Should I respin?
Respin.
All right.
I'd like to see your reaction to the rotten milk.
It's on the line, so we'll go strawberry banana or dead fish.
That sounds pretty rough.
So it's got to be a translucent red and
God, dude. My breath instantly smells terrible after that one jelly bean. I didn't think a jelly bean could do that. Did you pick out all the dead fish?
Well, because there's some that are like, it looks like peach and barf and strawberry banana and dead fish look so much alike. You know what I mean? I think it's the solider pink.
It looks lighter to me, to where it's like more of an orange than it is a pink.
You think that's it?
Yes. Yes, I do.
All right. Cheers.
Bottoms up, baby.
Yes.
Peach.
Strawberry banana.
Oh, strawberry banana.
Yeah.
Oh, fuck that yeah. Sounds great.
Woo! What a delicious jelly bean.
You know, I really want a jelly bean now, like a real one.
You must spin. Here, hold.
All those salty boogers gave me a sweet tooth.
If you hold, here, I'll hold it.
Okay, here we go. There we go. That was great.
What a spin.
Chocolate pudding or ground dog food?
I'm not afraid of this
one. I'm definitely not afraid of this one. I've had, definitely tried canned dog food, and it... only tastes a fraction of what boogers taste like.
It's that like muddy colored one. Wow, that was a really tasty jelly bean.
Yeah, just brown, right?
Yeah.
I second guessed it. I probably fucked it up. Got the dog food now. All right.
In you go.
Oh, that's definitely chocolate pudding.
Oh, fuck yeah. Nice. You deserve a good one.
Yeah.
Aren't the flavors great, though?
They are.
They're very good flavors.
Jelly Belly is the only brand. Like, you know...
They've really cornered the jelly bean market.
Yeah. You ever get those, like, off-brand, like, shitty jelly beans on, like, Easter or something? Where it's like you bite into them and it's just, like, a bunch of sugar crackles into your mouth?
The big, thick ones?
I hate those.
Yeah, I don't... I'm not a big jelly bean person in general.
Yeah.
But who is a big jelly bean person?
I would love to meet a jelly bean connoisseur.
Yes, like they have jelly beans like I have Funko Pops.
Yeah.
Like these are from 2002 line of exclusive piña colada flavor that only came out in 2002.
I mean, I would definitely love to meet that guy.
I wouldn't. Probably,
no?
Probably can't ride donkeys, that guy. All right.
Oh, fuck.
I'm spinning. No, it's the green.
No. We've had enough boogers.
Oh, shit. Son of a bitch, it's buttered popcorn or rotten egg.
That's not good.
No.
I wouldn't want either of those, honestly. Buttered popcorn is the worst Jelly Belly.
Yeah. Okay. But see, this one looks too much like the other ones, too. That's correct?
Definitely.
All right, we have confirmation.
You are good to swallow.
All right, here goes.
It's rotten egg. I saw your face curdle right when it touched your tongue.
Oh, God. Mm. Oh, it's bad.
Yeah?
It's amazing. They capture it so well.
Does it taste rotten? Or does it? Is it?
It's like, it tastes like a burnt egg.
Really?
Like I have an egg breath when I talk.
Okay. So you got that hot fart mouth now.
Mm-hmm.
Nice.
Oh, that was a bad...
I can see your pain. It's bringing me great pleasure.
No, I'm not into that. Not
after
into
those
that
boogers,
one.
Man, I was really hoping you were going to get a nasty one.
That was bad. All right.
All right. This is my final round.
Final spin.
How do you win?
You don't. Well, you win if you get like all goods.
Okay.
Like that's how I figure.
Get a nice sugar high.
So we've each had a good and a bad.
There we go. What are we looking at? I like the color. It's blue. Berry blue or toothpaste?
Fuck, that's a W.
I already win. It's the only blue one, huh?
Yeah.
Oh, sick. I don't even care.
You don't even give a fuck. That's a freebie.
It's toothpaste.
Toothpaste.
It's fucking delicious.
Damn it. I wanted you to get like rotten milk.
No, that's the one I did not want to get.
Watch, it's the one I get. Shit.
Dude, toothpaste is just bad mint.
Oh, God. Caramel corn or moldy cheese?
Mm.
For me.
Mm. I mean, technically, I got two bad ones, one good one. Technically. But honestly, I would eat another toothpaste without even having to.
Can you confirm that this is caramel corn or moldy cheese, please?
Yes. May I see the diagram?
Yes, good sir.
Confirmed.
Confirmed.
Yes. Go ahead and ingest that.
All right. Take it. Take all of it.
Oh. Is that cheese?
It's moldy cheese.
Oh, fuck, dude. I'm sorry.
It's like a sharp cheddar mold.
Mmm.
Oh, boy.
That's one sharp bean?
Oh, that's a sharp bean. Ugh.
Dude, chase it with a green one.
It's like all of my teeth. That's the other problem with these jelly beans is that like they stick around.
Yeah. No, the toothpaste really cleaned up my mouth. Like, you remember how I said I had bad breath? Well, that's all I needed was some toothpaste.
I need a blue. Oh, berry.
Oh. At least it's tasty.
Whew.
That toothpaste was like a mint, though. I feel like all back to normal after those boogers. Yeah.
Charlie, you win.
Yes.
You won the Bean Boozled Challenge. Congratulations, my friend.
Hell yeah. That was my first time. Beginner's luck,
well
I suppose.
Done.
Thank you.
The next person's fucked because we had a lot of good ones.
I know. You just pulled a blue. That's
Sorry.
One good flavor gone.
Sorry, we pulled the blue.
LeBron on the Lakers, dude.
Mm-hmm.
Fuck. I mean, I haven't been watching like too much of the preseason, but what I did see is like the Lakers are not looking good.
Really?
Yeah, dude.
They look bad?
I watched the two. All I've seen so far are the two first games of the preseason,
mm-hmm.
and it was fucked.
Really?
Yeah.
I didn't know you watched basketball.
My dad was a huge Lakers fan, so yeah. like, you know, since he passed away, it's like, I'm like, I've never been more into it.
Really?
Yeah.
That's good to know, because I love fucking basketball.
Fuck yeah.
We should go see LeBron.
Dude, I'm down as fuck.
We can go with Cody, if he's back on the show.
Is he? Oh, if his suspension is revoked?
Yeah, if he doesn't do any more infractions. But yeah, man.
I'm down, dude. I'll take any reason to go to a game.
I'm interested to see how he does there, because LeBron is like, he's not a type of player to like mix in. You have to like completely change your game.
I know, dude, because that's like,
he brings his own thing.
Yeah, I love how he like hates passing the ball.
Mm-hmm.
But I mean, like all those greats were like that though, like Kobe. That dude barely ever passed the ball.
No.
Shaq would if he was too far from the hoop.
LeBron will pass if he knows it'll make him look good.
Yeah.
But otherwise, he's gonna try to score.
Yeah. And it's like I'm starting from scratch right now, too, because in previous years, I fucking didn't give a shit about basketball, you know?
Dude, it's fun, man.
I love it. Like
It's very... This is going to sound weird me saying it, but it's very graceful.
Yeah.
You know, these are like, if you go to a game, these guys are like giraffes. They're
titans.
They are huge people. And like the way they're able to like glide down a court and like spin and like finesse, like they have to be like, they're so strong and so like physically able. But then, like, when they shoot, it's like they have to, like, fucking, like, tap it in or, like, just gracefully, like, tink.
It's like ballroom dancing, dude. That's what it kind of looks like, too.
Yeah, they're like, whoo, like, pirouette and, like, holy shit. Shoot, like, the feeling of a basketball, like watching it, like, and you can tell, like, oh, that's money. And then the sound, like, fucking wet.
Yeah,
wet basket.
Wet.
That was the thing. We'd shoot. Oh shit, Moxie's awake. We would like shoot, and like all the people, they'd be like, "Oh yo, that J was wet."
Oh yeah,
like a jump shot. Your J was wet because the net like.
See what like to the, me what that sounds like is someone got your joint wet, and that's. Terrible.
That's bad. Yeah.
You're going to get beat up.
Did you wet my J?
Or it could be really good.
Yeah. You could dip it in like acid?
No. I mean, there is a wet J in terms of your drugs.
Oh,
a
wet J PCP in it. Right?
I mean,
isn't
sure.
that what getting wet is?
No, I was talking in terms of sexual intercourse.
Oh, interesting.
Getting your J a little wet?
I understand.
No one likes a dry J in that sense.
No, did you ever see Training Day?
Fuck. If I did, I was like 13.
Well, he's like a dirty cop, Denzel Washington, and he makes this guy like smoke a joint, and like it has PCP in it.
Dude, that's the only scene in that movie I've ever seen.
Really? Yeah. He's like, come on, man, just hit this.
It was like on TNT one day, and I was flipping through, and it was on that scene, and I sat and watched the whole fucking thing.
And he's just driving, and he's like, I know you like to get wet. And then like Ethan Hawke's like, what the fuck? And he's like, PCP, you just smoked it.
Oh, my God.
And, like, his vision is getting all, like, fucked up. So that's how I know.
I need to watch that movie.
In that sense, the J is wet.
Mm-hmm. Fuck.
Or like smoking weed and PCP is called getting wet.
There probably isn't a saying for having a, like, if your penis is wet from a vagina.
Mm.
I don't think why would you call it a J?
Yeah, no.
No.
I've heard people say, like, I'm trying to get my dick wet.
Yeah.
This is very fratty.
Yeah. Dude, I just recently heard the expression, make thick in the warm.
What? Is that like Native American speak?
Make thick in the warm?
Is that like someone's name?
No, make thick.
Make
thick.
Make thick in the warm.
Yeah, dude. I thought that was the funniest shit.
All I can think of is like a Native American's name.
Oh, really?
Like Kicking Bird. Or like...
Thick in the warm.
Stands with fist. Make thick in the warm.
Oh, shit.
Make thick in the warm. Bring me some... Bring me a woven basket.
Oh, fuck. That's funny.
Yeah. Like, like Dances with Wolves.
Yeah. Yeah.
Make thick in the warm. Welcome. Please, come in my tent.
But it doesn't make sense to you?
Make thick in the warm.
Yeah.
Yeah, I get it.
Okay, cool.
I'm just saying it sounds...
Because you went straight to that.
Yeah, it just sounds like a Native American name.
Yeah.
Like, what would your Native American name be if you, like... Like, it's apparently... In Dances with Wolves... I'm not trying to be racist or anything, but in Dances with Wolves, they would name them things that they do that was crazy or things that they do on, like, a regular basis. Mm-hmm. So, like, my name might be, like, Talks and Mikes.
I think mine would be Eats the Whole Bag.
What? What's up, Eats with Whole Bag? Eats the Whole Bag?
Dude, those chips, man.
That's terrible.
Always. Always. Family size.
You eat the whole bag.
Eats the whole bag.
All right. Eats the whole bag. Charlie
Talks and Mikes.
A.K.A. Eats the Whole Bag. Talks and Mikes.
It kind of rolls off the tongue.
Talks into Mikes.
Talks into Mikes.
Or,
This is my guest. Eats the whole bag.
Bites the fingers.
Bites the fingers?
Yeah, I always bite my nails.
Oh.
Or eats the flesh.
Eats the flesh. Refuses any vegetarian food.
Yeah. Eats the McRibs.
He just eats McRibs.
Yeah, eats McRibs. There was
That one.
In Dances with Wolves, Kevin Costner was named Dances with Wolves.
Oh.
Yeah, that was his name.
I thought that movie was about dancing with wolves. I've never seen it. I'm not going to lie.
It's a great movie.
Really?
Dude, it's Avatar.
Really?
It's the same premise of Avatar.
Huh.
Weird American man gets like mixed up in like a native tribe and then like loves the tribe and then fights the...
His own.
Yeah, becomes... He basically becomes a Native American.
Fuck. I cannot
really cool.
wait for the next Avatar. I'm going to watch that
watch
to
Dance
get hyped
Wolves.
On Avatar 2.
Shit's dope.
Yeah.
And then he dates... this other white woman in the Native American tribe, but her name is Kicking Bird. No.
Because she kicks birds?
I guess so.
That's fucked up, dude.
No, I'm mistaken. Kicking Bird was somebody else. She was Stands with a Fist because she fought somebody.
Okay.
Yeah.
That's pretty sick.
Actually. Stands with Fists.
All right, I'm going to change mine then. Can my Native American name be Moshes with Hate?
No. It is Eats the Whole Bag.
Oh, okay. I'm fine. I'll stay with my first pick.
You are Eats the Whole Bag for the rest of your life.
All right. I got tattoo idea right there.
Moshes with Hate.
Moshes with Hate is just...
Maybe that can be your nickname. Moshes with Hate and Eats the Whole Bag. All right.
Eats the whole bag. God damn it. Why did I do that to myself? That was the first thing that came to mind.
That's it.
I ate a whole bag of Doritos last night.
You eat the whole bag. So, podcast is...
Grave Mistakes in Cinema.
Listen to that shit. And all your bands are on Spotify, right?
Yeah. This Place is a Zoo on Spotify. In Decline on Spotify. If you like that heavy shit, give us a listen, please.
And you got a show on Saturday.
Yeah, Lancaster, California. Not the one in like Pennsylvania or whatever. At Voodoo Vinyl, right on the boulevard.
Does it get confused Like, do people hit you up like, hey, man, I'm here?
Yes, we've gotten quite a few. Not that they're at the venue, but it was like, I can't find that venue anywhere in Lancaster. I'm like, which Lancaster? Because there's like four, dude. There's like really? One here, one in Pennsylvania. There's one in the UK.
Really? Yeah.
So all sorts of confusion there.
Lancaster, CA.
Yes.
Don't get it twisted.
Yeah. The middle of the fucking desert.
Thanks for coming on the podcast, man.
Thanks for having me, man. It was fun. A blast.
Good times.
I know. I can't remember the last time I ate a booger. Dude, that was buck wild.
You ate a booger, liked it, and talked about it.
Yeah.
Cool.
I savored it. I could have swallowed it way earlier than I did. Yeah, man, right, it was a good time. Thank you, Dan and Cody Podcast.
Paul Kayers.
Dan and Cody Podcast. You guys are the shit.
Thanks, dude.
Fucking appreciate it.
Thanks for listening and laughing with the Dan and Cody Podcast. Our email is danandcodypodcast@gmail.com. We're on Facebook. We're on Twitter. We are on Instagram @DanCodyPodcast. Check out our website, danandcody.com, and you can contribute to the podcast by going to patreon.com/DanCodyPodcast.
Subscribe, bitch!
Everybody play the tough guy to shoot, all right?